Welcome back to the Off Cycle. This is going to be part two of the vintage runabout restoration. I think today I'm going to go ahead and bite the bullet and just cut the floor out because that's going to be really the biggest thing to be done on this boat is cutting the floor out and getting that inspected and stringers replaced if they need to be, which I'm assuming they're probably going to need to be replaced. So I can get going on all that. I did do a bunch more research last night. And I'm not so sure that this is a 1969 Starcraft Falcon or whatever I thought it was. Most of those boats tended to be aluminum. And what I found out so far is that I think this boat was registered as homemade at one point. The VIN number is actually a sticker. So I'll go ahead and show y'all what the VIN is like on the boat and kind of go through the research that I've gone through about IDing this thing. So the hull ID number right here, even the title says 1969 because the last digit is 69, but based on this VIN format, this shouldn't even exist. This VIN format's from like 1984, if everything is correct as far as the decoding for the digits, and the letters and everything. So that didn't even exist till 1984, I think it was. And then boats weren't even required to have VINs until 1972. So if this is a 69, then it really shouldn't even have a VIN. And when I first looked at this, it looked like it was embossed and then filled in, especially because it's kind of like got some overspray on it right here. It looked like it was embossed, but I've realized that it's not. I did a FLZ. FLZ, it should be the manufacturer's ID code. And FLZ comes back to Florida Homemade Boats. So I'm really thinking that this boat was just registered as homemade at one point. And I don't think it has a HIN, which is good because it's telling me it's pre-1972. So I'm thinking I'm pretty close with my 1960s or so guess about the age of this boat. I did post it on some forums or some pages on Facebook for vintage boats, and some people are saying late 50s, early 60s. So it's still up in the air. I have no idea who made this boat, what model is, anything like that. So if anybody has any idea based on the shape of it, I've looked at hundreds and hundreds of boats on Google trying to find a match, and the one thing that's really unique about this boat is from the rub rail up, how the deck is high, carries all the way around. Most of them, the rub rail is high and then the deck is really low. So I really haven't seen anything with that shape. The bow is fairly round, it's somewhat pointed, but it's not super pointed like a lot of the boats are. So just has a unique shape. I've heard people say they're cobias, but I've not seen any cobia to match this shape. So I'm really, really at a loss. I don't know whether I'll find any other kind of identification marks or numbers or anything while I'm in here cutting out the floor or going through the boat, but I'm at a complete loss as to make, manufacturer, model, year, all that on this boat. So if you have any idea, please leave a comment and let me know. I was looking at this transom some more, and it looks like all of this, I think, is just a layer of resin. I think somebody just threw a layer of resin over wood, which really you can't do. It's not, if you're going to put resin over wood, like, you should probably at least thin it out so it soaks in better, but really it's just a layer of glass over it is really going to keep it from doing this. It's not really going to adhere to wood. So I could see there's glass right here where they did in the corner, and then they just put resin over the rest of the wood. I'm pretty sure this has definitely been replaced who knows how many times, but this actually looks like oak to me. This does not look like plywood. So when I pull this out, I'm guessing this is not even going to be plywood. It looks like red or white oak to me. So, which it's pretty firm. I don't even know if it's rotted out, but it's definitely delaminated here. And it's actually, the hull is actually, I don't know if that's the hull that's cracked or that's one of the pieces of fiberglass they laid in here and that is cracked and is delaminating. So I'm going to have to grind this out and see what all I have in there. But First things first is I'm gonna cut the floor out before I mess with the transom, because I might have to build something to put this motor on. And once I build something to put this motor on, then I'll mess with the transom. But for now, that's just gonna be left. So today I'm gonna cut the floor out, but I might go ahead and rip out all the wiring and everything underneath there, because as of right now, I have something flat to lay on, get to get underneath there and do that. If I rip the floor out right now, then it's gonna be pretty nasty and I'll be laying on stringers and all that. So I think it'll be more comfortable for me to get all that stuff out, and I'll just put it in a Tupperware bin or something for storage for now until I'm ready to use it and remake the dash and everything. So I think I'm actually gonna do that first and then cut the floor out. So here's what it looks like underneath the dash. There's actually quite a bit of wiring things up in here between the gauges and the old radio. I've already taken the old VHF radio out, the antenna out, the whole steering mechanism and everything is here. It's free, which is nice. I'm not seized up or anything, but the old cassette player and I don't know if this is the, I'm assuming this is probably the engine alarm buzzer right here. So I'm gonna take some pictures of this just to document kind of where everything was, but I think this, all this wiring is much more complicated than it really needs to be. There's a lot more in here than I'll probably be putting back in here. Some of these gauges and stuff won't even go back in. Like this, this right here is the little transducer with the depth finder. I'm probably not even gonna put that back in. I just want it to be real simple and clean. I'm not gonna be running this thing anywhere other than like the intercoastal. I'm not gonna be running it in the flats or anything where I'm worried about the depth. And if there's a rock or something, then you're gonna hit that before you even see it on the depth finder when you're running, so. And there is a little dome light in here that at least somebody glued a piece of plywood there and screwed this to that instead of screwing into the deck. But there is holes and stuff in the deck. This is the four bolts for the cleat on front. I'm probably gonna cut a plate, aluminum plate for that, just to disperse the weight a little more. I'm not sure if this is wood inside of this or foam, so I have to find a hole that's I can see into fairly well. But all, most of the holes that are going into this actual laminated piece here are small, so I can't really see into there. But I'm thinking it was foam in there, maybe, just by the way it sounds. But who knows? It could be wood. Not sure. Water in your transom when you take some screws out of it that was on a speedometer pickup and you got water just free flowing out of there. Got a little bit of water in the transom. Alright, so I've got all the wiring out, the dash outs, all the gauges, everything. The only thing left sticking in there is the old hour meter. I couldn't get to that without taking the steering out, and I just took the steering out and went to free up the steering cable, but I'm not going to be able to remove the steering until I get the motor off, because the way this steering cable bends, I can't, there's no way I'm going to be able to pull it far enough. It'll hit right here before I'll ever get this actuator out of the other side of the motor. So that's going to have to wait. So that's just overhanging on the side of the boat, and I'm ready now to start cutting the floor out. I got my angle grinder. I'm actually using a tile cutting blade. I think that's going to make a little less dust than like an abrasive disc. So I'm going to go get my respirator and set this camera up, and we'll go ahead and cut this floor out. I'm sure it's going to be atrocious underneath. And that side, and this is where the little transducer was for the little mini depth finder. Since I took this out, I had water running out of this too, so I'm sure the whole floor underneath is just full of water and just saturated. I don't know if there's foam under there or not. If there's foam under there, I'm sure it's completely saturated. So We'll see shortly. So I've got part of the floor cut out, my phone overheated doing the time lapse, so I didn't get pulling the floor out on the time lapse, sorry about that. But it doesn't look as bad as I was expecting. There's lots of larvae down here from the insects and things. A lot of this glass over these stringers is really not, it's not sealed. I think it's just a single layer, but it's really not sealed. So the stringers at the top seem dry. I'll have to probe them at the base. Like over here, it seems like they've been eaten away underneath. So I'm probably gonna end up just doing new stringers anyway. But then I still gotta cut the front out. It's just finding the right line where the floor is and not cutting through the hull, because right here, that's just hull. There's no flooring there. And I think it starts right about there. So just gotta cut up into the V and then peel that one out. But it's about to rain, so I'm taking a break and I'm gonna go ahead and spray this out as much as I can so I can get a good clear inspection on it when it dries. Thanks for tuning in for the second part of this vintage runabout restoration. I've got half the floor out. I did get rained out again today, so I headed inside and the rain is past now, but I'm cleaned up and about to head to dinner. So we're done for the day on this. I'll pick up tomorrow and probably get the front part of the floor cut out and we'll go from there. So make sure to check back and look for episode 3. Should be coming up in the next few days.